Putting it in the areas that I see that my hair is thinning. I don't have any bald spots. My hair has fallen out, but my hair was falling out last year when I was doing the radiation. It hasn't fell out in these recent months since I've stopped radiation and completed. But now my issue is that my hair is starting to thin out, especially on the sides. So there's that issue. My skin. So as you know, I've had my surgery for my partial mastectomy, lumpectomy, was on this breast, and I had two of my lymph nodes removed, and I've had discoloration and stuff here, as I'm going to put in this photo clip right here. So now that has cleared up. It's still a little dark. I would show you guys an update, but I don't want to be too graphic for you guys for you to see it. So that's the update on my skin. The doctors have gave me this ointment that you're supposed to treat. And if you don't have that kind of ointment that's available, you can use A&D ointment. But this ointment that they gave me is like a little more smoother and a little bit more easier on the skin. It's not as thick as A&D ointment. So I'm going to do the process now of injecting myself while I'm talking to you guys, so that you can see that it's not that hard. And it does come in a priority hazmat container, and it's called Eligard, and I guess it's the generic brand to Lupron, because apparently there's a shortage of Lupron in the whole of New York, which is weird. But so I have to use Eligard. Like I said, I believe it's the generic brand, and they gave me a you know, when you go to the doctor's office to get rid of needles and stuff like that, they gave me one of those to place on my needles and stuff, because you can't dispose that. You can't dispose of that just in regular garbage in fear of whatever people do nowadays with needles. So, that's that. Injection sites. Let's talk about that. So, injection sites. If you inject it in the same site more than twice, it starts to get irritated. So I tried to switch it up. Then when you go to the doctor, sometimes they normally inject it in the back of my arm, or they'll do like the fatty area of my stomach, or they would do like the upper part of my thigh. Now recently, I've just been rotating those four injection sites. But I think I'm just gonna start a new site today, because I see that my skin is slightly irritated on my upper thighs because I've been using that as an injection site. So once you're doing your self-injection, you do have to sanitize the area. I'm about to sanitize it right now. Give you all these little bandages. I don't really need the band-aids because I don't really bleed really like that. I just need the gauze. And the gauze help with it's a little blood. It's not a lot of blood that what happened. So you really don't need a band-aid, honestly. So everything comes package is sterilized. Like I said, you have to sanitize the area, which is what I already did. I had to do it twice because you know, it's summertime, so you know, mosquitoes are out, so you have to deal with that now, being at the summertime, and you have to constantly wear put alcohol on your skin to prevent, you know, mosquito bites. So here I'm just mixing in the two formulas and you gotta mix it in until it's like a pasty white color. So you gotta do that for a few. Once it gets pasty, see how it gets milky. Done, then you just untwist. Make sure all of the medication is thoroughly transferred. Once that's done, you have to apply the needle. Now we're trying to get every drop of medicine in here, because sometimes medicine doesn't fully go in. So once that's done, and then you place the needle on top, you screw it in because it's a screw top, and then pull this back, and then that's your needle. So once that's done, I'm going to do my arm for you guys to see. Take alcohol pad, let it dry for a little bit, and now when you're doing your injection, you have to do it at a 90 degree angle. You can't stab it down, you have to do it at an angle so it can get underneath the skin. So sometimes I necessarily don't like looking, but I'm gonna look for the sake because I'm doing this on camera. So it's 1, 2, 3. And then inject. Now it does burn. That's the only thing I don't like about this medication, is that it burns when it goes in. Like, it really burns. It feels like, what's the best way to describe it? It feels like somebody is taking like a hot poker for like a couple seconds. Oh, you know what? Best way to describe it. Have you ever had a tattoo and get this tattoo and get this tattoo and it's just, they keep irritating the same spot over and over again? That's basically how that feels. Like, the needle is just there and it's irritating and it's burning and you just want to get it over with. So that's basically how this feels. So after you do that, of course you gotta put everything back in its original case and then you have to dispose of it. And then that's it. That's the end of the injection. So, like I said, see, it's no bleeding. It's just, like I said, the site area is burning right now. It takes a little while for it to go away. Once that goes away, that's the end of that. But, yeah. So, see you on my next one. Thank you guys for watching Journey to 30. Bye.